G'day. There's two great things about this video. The first one is it'll give you some guidance on how to become an inspirational business communicator. Because one thing that inspirational business communicators do is that they give great answers to tough questions, whether they're tough questions from clients, from prospects, from their own team, from officials, or from journalists. So we're going to give you a bit of a clue as to what happens when I'm running sessions at conferences, in mastermind groups, and in one-to-one training situations. The second piece of good news is that we have on this video a star. We have the star of a movie that's coming out later this year called The Redeeming, and it will be absolutely worth watching, partly because the star of that is Tracey Ann Wood, a highly accomplished actress who is lending us her talents here today. And we are privileged to have her because she is going to play the part of someone giving bad answers and great answers. And you're going to be able to see the difference. What we're going to do the first time is she's going to do a fairly bad bunch of answers. And hopefully you can spot a couple of the things that she'll be doing wrong. And these things are ones that I pick up day after day, week after week, year after year in the business world. And by changing them, we can actually help you give better answers. And then Tracey Ann Wood is going to use her great acting skills to actually turn it around and do better the second time. So you'll be able to spot some really great answers and learn along the way. So let's go for it in 3, 2, 1. So, Miss Freeman, as a potential client for your company, there's something I've picked up from people around the place, which is that while you provide a really good service, that you're not so good on reliability. In fact, your company's often unreliable and that you frequently miss deadlines. Is that true?
No, I don't think that's true at all. We're not unreliable in any way, and we don't miss deadlines. Absolutely not.
And the other thing I've picked up is, again, while they're saying the service you provide is really good, which is why I'm interested in exploring this, they're saying that you sometimes overcharge and that you can be seen as being just way too expensive. What do you say about that?
No, we're not way too expensive at all. Absolutely not. We don't overcharge. No, definitely not.
Okay. Thank you very much for that. So what you've seen there is what often happens in the real world, where when subject to tough questioning, what we call in Australia where I'm from, blowtorch-on-the-belly questioning, the person repeats back a negative: unreliable, missing targets, overcharging, expensive. And what you need to do in that situation is, while we expect you to give absolutely honest answers, is to not repeat back negative words, because that leaves a negative impression. What you need to do off the back of those kind of questions is to actually use your own positive words to describe what you're talking about. That puts you way, way, way more in control. So watch for that. The other thing to watch for is your body language. When people are judging how you look, how you sound, and what they think of you, they make that judgment very much on what your arms are doing and what your eyes are doing. And you'll notice the first time around, Tracey had her arms down and they're looking very defensive. And if you do have your arms across yourself like that, you look as though you're on the run. And what I want people to do typically is to be up and open. And if you're giving honest answers with a positive message, it's so much easier to do that. The open hands signal nothing to hide and that you're really keen to engage. And the eyes are really important. You make sure you're looking at the eyes of the other person so that you are really engaging with them. Eyes up can look as though, God, give me the answers, I don't know what they are. Eyes down can be, yes, I'm the guilty person, I'm responsible for all the overcharging and for the massively high charges, etc. So you need to keep that eye contact, because people will judge you on it. So we're going into take two now with Tracey Ann Wood again appearing as Miss Freeman, and we'll see how she goes this time. So, Ms. Freeman, I've been thinking about doing business with your company, but I am concerned, having been asking around, about reliability. And while people are saying that the service is very good, some of your critics say that you are unreliable and that you miss deadlines. Is that true?
XYZ is a really, really reliable company. And actually, we managed to hit 98.3% of our targets. I would say that's really very reliable. And we aim to make it 100%. In the rare occasion that may not happen, we always reimburse our client, the company, 100%. So they're always getting good value.
Okay. And when it comes to this claim that you charge too much, with some people saying that you're overcharging and that while you provide a good service that you are very expensive, how do you respond to that?
XYZ is really, really good value for money. And this has been proven by an independent market survey which was carried out, and it was found that we're actually 12.5% lower than the average in cost. So we really, really are good value for money. And also in the survey, there was feedback from customers, from clients, which was overwhelming, that people are really, really actually very, very happy with our services.
Okay, thank you very much. Sounds like there's a lot for us to consider there. So thank you very much, Ms. Freeman, and thank you very much, Tracey Ann Wood. So you can see what Tracey Ann Wood is doing there. She's a very fast learner, as actors can be when they're under pressure. And the second answers were so much better because she actually used positive words. She didn't repeat back the negative. And she also made sure that her body language was so much better. Her hands were apart. Her eye contact was good. And therefore, she made a much more positive impression. And, you know, we can learn from actors like Tracey Ann, because actors, what do they do before they go on stage? What do they do before they have their big moment in the spotlight? They plan, they prepare, and they practice. Now, it's not to say that you are actually acting when you're in that role, but we do want you to realise it is a performance. So when you are there having those tough conversations with clients and prospects, officials or journalists, you are there in the spotlight performing, and if you've planned, prepared and practiced, you will do so much better. And that's the kind of thing that we do with you at Michael Dodd Communications. We do one-to-one training, we do training in masterclasses where we can run one-off masterclass or a program of masterclasses, or I can come to your conference and demonstrate great practice and appalling practice so that your people can actually see the difference on stage at your conference and know what is the best way to approach future communication challenges, and in particular, how to give great answers to tough questions. So thanks again to Tracey Ann Wood for actually coming on this video for us. And she is appearing in the feature film The Redeeming, which will be coming out later this year. And it really is worth watching for so many reasons. It is high quality entertainment with a great star who on screen you will absolutely love. So if you need more information about boosting your communication skills, visit www.michaeldoddcommunications.com and you'll be able to see the range of ways where you can actually become an inspirational business communicator yourself.